In this session, we are going to understand what is hire purchase system, and we'll also be understanding what is installment sales system. So why these systems have come into existence? It is not always possible for, say, the purchaser, if they want to buy goods which has high demand and high cost, because you have to make immediate cash payment. But on the other side, you need the goods, but you don't have full cash to purchase the goods. So to support these kind of purchases, this hire purchase concept had come into the market, and it is very popular. So in the system, what will happen? The purchaser, that is hirer, he will pay the amount for the goods in a staggered way. That is, he may be making payment either on monthly or quarterly or early basis with some interest. So when goods are sold in this model, they'll be sold with certain specific condition. Condition number one will be possession of goods will be delivered to hirer, but title of the goods, that is the ownership, will be transferred only when he pay the agreed sum. That agreed sum is otherwise called as hire purchase price. Only when hirer pays that agreed sum in totality, the ownership will be transferred, but delivery will be made in the beginning itself. Okay, and it also comes along with some kind of relief for the hirer. That is, hirer has got the right to terminate the agreement at any time, but it does not mean that he has the option to return the goods, in which case he need not pay installments falling due thereafter. Okay, but one point is, hirer cannot recover the sums already that has been paid by him, because these sums, they legally represent the higher charges of the goods that were given to him. And another condition will be, during this period, the hirer, that is hire purchaser, during this period, that is during the possession of goods, cannot damage, destroy, or pledge or sell these goods. He should take care of goods as a prudent person who will do that in his own goods. Okay, so these three are the critical things related to hire purchase system, that is possession of goods. If you notice the possession of the goods, it will be transferred to the hirer, but title will be transferred only when the agreed sum is paid. Hirer has got the right to terminate, but hirer cannot recover the sums which he has already paid because they represent the higher charges. Then during the period of possession of goods, hirer cannot damage or destroy, pledge or sell the goods. Okay, he should take care of the goods as a prudent person who does on his own goods. So that's about hire purchase. Then what is this installment sale system? In case of installment sale, what will happen is both the possession as well as the ownership of the goods will be transferred to the buyer immediately at the time of agreement. Okay, in case of hire purchase, it is only the possession that is transferred, whereas in case of installment sale, it is both the possession and ownership will be transferred to the buyer at the time of agreement. And in installment system, if the buyer is going to stop the payment of dues, okay, then the seller will not have the right of seizing the goods, but that right was available in hire purchase. That is, if the hire purchaser is not going to make the installment, then the seller can seize the goods, can take back the goods. Okay, whereas in case of installment sale, if the buyer is going to stop the payment of dues, then he does not have the right of seizing the goods. Okay, so what we'll do, we'll understand the differences between the installment sale and hire purchase sale. So let's see one by one. Hire purchase and installment. First is with regard to ownership. If you take hire purchase, ownership will pass to the buyer only when he makes the last installment, because only by that time he would have paid the higher purchase price. Okay, because that's what we have here, only by that time, only by last installment, he will pay the higher purchase price. Only then ownership will transfer in higher purchase. But in case of installment sale, ownership will pass at the time of sale. Okay, so it is not necessary that he should pay all installments. Ownership is going to get passed in the beginning itself. Second aspect that causing difference between HP and installment sales is default in making payment. In higher purchase, if the hirer is going to default, then seller can repossess the goods. In that case, whatever the installment he has paid, it will be treated as hiring charges. But in case of installment sale, seller do not have any other right. I mean, he cannot go and repossess the goods, he cannot seize the goods, but the only right is right of suing the buyer for non-payment of the price. Then third difference is with regard to right of sale or otherwise. In case of higher purchase, hirer has no right to sell or transfer the goods because the legal position of the hirer is only as that of bailee. Whereas in case of installment sale, the buyer has got right to sell or otherwise transfer the goods because he is the owner of the goods. And fourth difference is with regard to loss or damages. In case of higher purchase, any loss that are occurring to goods, loss occurring to goods have to be borne by the seller because the legal ownership is with the seller and buyer is only taking reasonable care. Whereas in case of installment sale, whatever loss that occurs to goods, loss occurring to goods have to be borne by the buyer. Okay, so these are all the differences between higher purchase and installment sale.